Hi everyone, today we are going to discuss some previous year questions from the CBSE graded chemistry. So let's start from the first lesson, chemical reactions and equations. So this is actually a CBSE previous year question paper on 2018, and I am taking question number 15 that is coming from the first lesson. The question is, decomposition reactions require energy either in the form of heat or light or electricity for breaking down the reactants. So write one equation each for decomposition reactions where energy supplied in the form of heat, light and electricity. As you know, decomposition reaction means breaking down of a compound by using heat, light or electricity. So you can use heat, so accordingly we call it as thermal decomposition. This is thermal decomposition. Then you can use light energy to decompose a compound, so it's called photolytic decomposition or photolysis, and you can use electricity to decompose a substance, it's called electrolytic decomposition or electrolysis. So now we are going to write one chemical equation for each of these three. So first I am writing thermal decomposition. The simplest example you can write here is heating of calcium carbonate. So calcium carbonate formula is CaCO3. So on heating, so you can write here the energy, heat energy. So you will get the product as calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. And carbon dioxide is gas and it is liberating out when you heat calcium carbonate. And the calcium oxide, this is calcium oxide and it is solid residue. This is the simplest example you can write for thermal decomposition. And the second reaction is photolytic decomposition. It's also called a photolysis. Here you can give a simple example as decomposition of silver chloride, AgCl, silver chloride. This is on exposure to sunlight, you will get silver as solid residue and chlorine gas. Now when you look at the balancing of chemical equation, you can understand that chlorine on the right hand side, two atoms over here, but when you look at the left hand side, reactant side, you have only one chlorine atom. I'm just writing two over here. So now chlorine is balanced, 2Cl, but when you put two on the left hand side, the number of silver atom is increased. So I need to balance silver atom here, so I'm just putting two over here. Now the equation is balanced. So 2AgCl on exposure to sunlight, you will get 2Ag plus Cl2. So this is the simplest example for photolytic decomposition. Now the third one is electrolytic decomposition. Here you can think about the electrolysis of water. This is a two simple example you can write for electrolytic decomposition. So write energy here, that is electricity. Okay, now when you pass electricity through water, you know what, pure water is not a conductor of electricity, so you need to add little acid. So when you pass electricity through water, it will decompose to form hydrogen and oxygen. So you will get hydrogen plus oxygen. And both are gases, and on the reactant side we have one oxygen atom, but when you move on to the product side you have two oxygen atoms. So I'm just putting two over here to balance the chemical equation. Now 2H2O, you will be getting H2 plus O2. Now when you put two on the left hand side, number of hydrogen atoms also increased. Now it become 2 into 2, it's 4. So I'm putting two over here. Now the balanced chemical equation is 2H2O, 2H2 plus O2. So these are the three examples for decomposition reactions: thermal decomposition, photolytic decomposition, and electrolytic decomposition.